Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Now we begin our journey into the Malay lost and forgotten world. Now the Malay language and its secret to the world and the creation of humanity. Now when we talk about language, what does it mean? What does language being defined? What is the real meaning to the language of mankind? Now, language is Bahasa Melayu, Bahasa. The Malay language is the most dominant language or the lingua franca of the ancient civilization. It has its root and its lineage, including its traces from Northern America, Southern America, China, Japan, and at every corner of the world. Now, as we began our journey to trace back our ancient lineage to the first forefather, our first mother and father. So, human must return back to its nature, its traces and its roots. But for us to go digging across thousands of years, it will be a difficult journey. As such, let us begin today to return back to the primordial language of humanity. In the clothing as a Malay, bahasa jiwa bangsa. Bahasa jiwa bangsa means language is the soul of the Malay race. And the soul of the Malay race is the covenant, the light of God, and the secret of mankind. During our early stages of life, when we are inside the body of our mother, within the early stages of creation, there is a language, the language of the soul, whereby during our timeline inside the womb of our mother, including humankind first son or daughter inside the womb of Eve, the first primordial mother, when the element of the world or the earth, fire, wind, air and earth, including whatever form of physical manifestation that revolve around the secret or the sun or the jiwa or the raga, we are being woven, dalam bahasa Melayu kita ditenun, ditekat, ditempa, we are being converted into what we are here today. Our eyes, our ears, our physical manifestation is just the outer realm. Within the layer, the fabric of our creation, either we look from the eye of the physics, the quantum mechanics, the quantum physics, we are also a part of the illusion or the vision being portrayed across the soul of other created being across the multi-realm. Now, when we talk about the Malay is a forgotten race. The Malay are now being undermined in their own land. In our own motherland, we are being discriminated. We are being, what they call it, far-sighted, or we are being pandang sebelah mata. We are being degenerated. We are being stepped upon in our own motherland. From other people that live within the Malay territory, and including the Malay themselves, they have seen that they seem to be forgotten. They have lost traces of their originality, their ancient lineage and the language of their forefather or their foremother. As such, today, as the pilot video of the Malay legacy, the Malay secret, the Malay relationship with the world, the Malay relationship to the first forefather, and the Malay knowledge and attachment or relationship with the Creator. I'm not standing here in front of the audience talking about race. I'm in front of you talking about language. The language which is the medium of communication between the first human with the Creator, between the first father and mother to their son and daughter. During my journey, I have found out that within the Malay language, there exists a primordial bond that has sustained, that has survived until today. Its core essence, the primordial covenant between mother and father and the children of humanity or human. We are called keluarga Melayu, meaning keluar, to go out from ga, which is surga, which is heaven. So the Malay family unit are being identified as people or the son of Adam or a race of tribal group of people that have descended or have embarked beyond the first placement of humanity, which has been identified as Eden or heaven, heaven on earth or heaven above the cloud. Now, as we begin our first step, our first baby step, to embark on the search, to return back to the center point or the first dot, the first cradle of civilization, Pentasunda, the cradle of humanity, the place where some researcher has claimed is the first placement of the Garden of Eden on earth. As such, let's be frank this morning. I'm talking to you in English. I'm not talking in Malay. But later on, as the follower or as the viewer embark in my journey to return back to the primordial state of being, in my soul searching and in my physical searching to return back to the Garden of Eden or to the first place whereupon our first forefather Adam and Eve descended to us. Now let's return back to language. There is a language between the mother to the son or to the daughter. There is a language across all the plane of creation between the mother, the son and daughter, and the son to the mother and the father, which has been given or has been buried or have been received through the genetic foundation of the human creation. Now, in the Malay language, we define our language as Bahasa. Bah meaning flood. Sa meaning the one, the singular, the only one point of reference, the only one unified theory. So the language of the unified theory or the language of the primordial oneness of all created beings or all created manifestation. So in a simpler term, Bahasa meaning being flooded with the language of the Creator, the singular, the monotonous, the one and the only one. Without the unity of creation, without the singular center point of command and control center, our earth, the whole galaxy will be in chaos. So the Bahasa Melayu have been identified as being bombarded, being flooded, being controlled by the force of the one. This is the Bahasa Melayu that's being spoken by the Malays across the ages. So what is language? Why does language exist? In whatever form, in whatever mode of sound that being spoken across the plane of existence. There is the language of the bird. There are the language of the pig. There is the language of the monkey. There is the language of nature. The language of nature. The secret between the one being created and the creator. There must be a point of reference. There must be a point of communication. There must be a point. There must be a standardization or SOP between the created being to convey, to connect, to be in constant connection with the creator. Now, if we are to return back to the primordial state of being, we must return back to the primordial language, the primordial firman, the primordial word of God, which in its essence must have the exact component, the light, the air, the earth, the frequency, and the friction or the tone that we call the language of the God, or the language that can change or can changes whatever forces in nature. Behind any movement, behind any particle, behind every atomic friction or movement, there is certain pattern, polarity, algorithm, and a symphony or the orchestra of nature. So the Malay language can also be identified as the floodgate, coming from the singular point of existence, Sumer, Sumerian, the first emerges or emerging of the water of life. By whatever mode we begin to look into the Malay language, we don't want to go into the color or the creed or the pakaian or the clothing that are being worn by the Malay, including my tanja, the way I put the clothes around my neck. There always exists a symbolism between the first human that descended from heaven to this world, the Adamic family, the first primordial human being, the first mother and father legacy, is not being lost actually. It has been forgotten. While the world are being conned, being misled, being deceived in search of the mountain of God, Tursina, Mount Sinai, the city of light, the city of Adam, the Garden of Eden, the first place whereby the first house where Adam and Eve descended or live can be identified in the Malay language as rumah, meaning roh, the placement of the soul. When we began to return back to the Malay manuscript, and how the Malay give name, or how does a Malay identify things, and how does the Malay place the name, its root, its origin, in synchronicity or in the light of the first light of creation. Now then we start to see that the Malay language contain the light of God. As such, this is my first video. I'm still trying to get the lingo, the rhythm, the wave of how I want to identify the Malay in English language, and how I want to shift between the two language between the old language and the new language, or the one that have diverted from the primordial language of the first family. We will meet again in my second video. To end the first video, I would like to share my life story. I was born a Malay. I was given life and appear in this world in 1970. I was born in 1970. Now I am 54 years old. I've been to America. I stayed there for 10 years. I was asked to return back to my motherland by the late Prime Minister Tun Dr. Mahathir Mohamad. While he was attending a conference unveiling multimedia super corridor, the early stages where the internet came into existence. From 2001 to 2024, I'm here in my motherland. Now, as I am here, in my motherland, I will die in this land. I will be buried in my motherland. So, it is about time. At the golden years or at the end of my life, I need to find out. I need to return back to the first point of creation. As simple as I can put it in a simple form of word. 'Turtle, elephant and certain created animal, they will, like the salmon, they will return back to the first place where they are being brought up. Salmon will die at the end of their life cycle at the river where they are being born or exist in this world. In 2024, in across any religious ideology and circle, this era is being identified as the end of days. In Malay, we call it Akhiru Zaman. In Hinduism, it is called the Dark Ages before the coming of the Avatar or the Kalki Avatar. In Judaism or in Christianity, we are awaiting the return of Jesus Christ. In Judaism, they are waiting for the coming of the Messiah. In Pentasunda and Nusantara, we are awaiting the arrival of Sang Kinasih or Satrio Peninggit or Ratu Adil, the Queen of Justice, the warrior and the Ratu Adil to bring about justice to the world. It is sad to see the state of the being or the state of humanity at this current state of being. We are a lost son and daughter of our forefather Adam and Eve. The world is in chaos. We cannot seem to find our way back home. In Malay, there is a saying, this is a name or terminology where we say kampung halaman, meaning the first village of created being, the first village of humanity, the ancient village of Adam and Eve. It is embedded, encoded within the Malay cosmological or philosophical perspective. Every Malay must return back to their kampung halaman. Before the coming of Islam, every Malay soul will have to be returned back to the kampung halaman or to the first village or the center of Adam city-state or the city of light. Every single Malay children is being identified as the son of light, cahaya mata, meaning the light to the eyes. Once a Malay is being identified as the sun or the light of the eye, witnessing the light. Now, who are the Malay? They are the children of the city of the light. We shall continue in our next video in a much proper. I will be reading my first book in English regarding the Malay, its language, its secret connection with the forefather of with the first family of humanity. We shall meet again, asal muasal. In English, unity or the one is where it all begin. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh.